मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स बिगिन अवर स्टडीज विद चैप्टर नंबर 18, द एनवायरनमेंट एंड अस, दैट इज अ ईवीएस वन सब्जेक्ट. ओके, सो टेक आउट योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स फास्ट. ऑन पेज नंबर 89, deforestation. So student, what is deforestation? Deforestation is nothing but clearing forest. Okay, so what is the need for clearing forest? Because our country is a developing country, we need proper roads, railways, big ground for industrialization, for setting up factories. Okay, so for this, what we are doing is we are clearing forest. So if we clear forest, what will happen? Forest is a place for wild animals. Wild animals live in forest. So indirectly, for our profit, for our development, we are disturbing our environment by cutting forest. We are destroying the shelter of animal. Animal love to live in jungle and we are clearing up the forest. So that is deforestation. समझ में आया आपको? Deforestation किसे कहते हैं? इसी को deforestation कहते हैं. Yes? So it totally disturbs the environment. डिफॉरेस्टेशन मतलब पूरी तरह से देखो तो पूरा एनवायरनमेंट जो है वो डिस्टर्ब हो जाता है. एनिमल विल बिकम एक्सटिंक्ट. देर इज नो बायोडाइवर्सिटी सीन इन एनिमल्स. नॉट इवन इन एनिमल्स, व्हाट अबाउट द प्लांट्स? प्लांट्स आर डिस्ट्रॉयड. तो फिर आपको प्लांट्स भी नहीं मिलेंगे उतने वराइटीज के. एक जंगल क्लियर होने के कारण प्लांट्स भी नहीं मिलेंगे आपको. एनिमल्स तो मिलेंगे ही नहीं, बट प्लांट्स आर ऑल्सो नॉट सीन. प्लस इट डिस्टर्ब द बैलेंस बिटवीन द प्लीजन एनवायरमेंट. ओके, सो हाउ प्लीजेंट इज लुक? यू कैन से गुड एनवायरमेंट, फॉरेस्ट, चीपिंग ऑफ बर्ड्स, देयर एवरीवेयर ग्रीनरी, इट विल have very pleasant atmosphere, rain will also there. Yes, you can just imagine कि वो कितना अच्छा लगता है वो दृश्य. But only because of us, all these things is devastated. हमने उसे खत्म कर दिया पूरी तरह से, कुछ नहीं रह गया. क्योंकि हमें क्या चाहिए? रेलवे चाहिए, घर चाहिए, फैक्ट्री चाहिए. So where is land? There is no land available on the earth because of the growing population. What do the builder will do? Naturally, builder will cut up the trees. He will clear the forest area and he will set up building over there because there is no option for him. Okay, so this is deforestation. Now, forest is devastated by we peoples. We have set up industries. हमने industries बनाए. We have made roads, railways, etc. Because of this, what happens? Pollution increases. Pollution बढ़ने लग गया. Air pollution, then land pollution, soil pollution and water pollution. Everything which is there, it started getting polluted. Right? एयर पोल्यूशन कैसे हुआ? इंडस्ट्रीज दे एमिट हार्मफुल स्मोक टॉप इन टू द एटमोसफियर थ्रू द चिमनी. दिस एयर मिक्सेस विद द नॉर्मल एयर एंड पोल्यूट द एनवायरमेंट. व्हाट अबाउट द वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट? सम ऑफ द हार्मफुल कंटेंट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रीज आर लेट इन द रिवर बॉडीज. Ultimately, this river is also getting polluted. River water, which normally we use for drinking, or carrying out other activities, it also have been reduced. So that is also wrong. Didn't see how air pollution causes, how water pollution leads. And now, land pollution. Too much garbage. Pura kachra is accumulated on the land. Land pollution. So, in this manner, we are disturbing our pleasant environment by the process of deforestation, that is cutting our forest. Is that clear? So with this, I have cleared the topic of deforestation. Pollution. You have seen how water source get polluted if wastewater is let into them without processing. You can see here, students, your small picture is given, very clear picture. See here, some industries are there and they have let their harmful water into the river bodies. So it is causing water pollution. Wastewater flowing out from the factory into the surrounding. Wastewater also gives out from factory into their surrounding. If water from such polluted sources keeps soaking into the soil, the soil will become impotent. You can see here, wastewater from the factory enters the water body. Here also one picture is shown how wastewater from the factory is coming into the water body. So if such water is soaked into the ground, it will, the land become saline. The land pollution take place. Soil pollution take place. Okay. If water from such polluted source keeps soaking into the soil becomes infertile. Chemical fertilizer and pesticides are used on large scale for agriculture. They seep into the soil or finally flow into the river and rainwater. Due to several such reasons, water and soil get polluted. This is dangerous for animal and plants. Their number reduces and eventually they die. Although that is, they become extinct. Okay, students. Fuel is used in all home. Besides, there are big industries and factories in which fuel is used in great quantities. On one hand, tremendous quantity of carbon dioxide enter the air due to burning of fuel. On other hand, due to large-scale deforestation, number of trees available for absorbing this carbon dioxide gas is dwindling. As a result, the proportion of carbon dioxide in the air is rising continuously. When the proportion of carbon dioxide gas in the air rises, it leads to rise in temperature. Carbon dioxide gas is having ability to gain more temperature, more heat. That is why the temperature of the atmosphere increases. We see such temperature rises in all parts of the world. Besides, when fuel are burned in vehicle, they give out certain poisonous gas as well as smoke. Industries also let out some poisonous gases into the air. This leads to air pollution on the large scale. This leads to air pollution on the large scale. Yes, students, in last session we have seen the deforestation and pollution. In this session, we are going to discuss about need to maintain environmental balance. क्या जरूरत है बैलेंस बनाए रखने की? Okay, so due to the human intervention in nature, large scale changes are taking place in the air, water and land. Also, these non-living or the abiotic components are getting polluted. What are the abiotic components? Students, abiotic components are the components which are non-living things like soil, water, air, all these are the components coming under abiotic. Okay. And what will come under biotic? Microorganisms, animals, birds. Yes, all living world would come under the biotic components. Okay, so as a result, the existence of living things is threatened, while several living things have already become extinct. If one factor of the environment is damaged, its relation with the other factor also get affected and environmental balance is disturbed. If any one factor, if it is disturbed, means other factor will also get disturbed. Barabar? So balance is necessary. From time to time, some of the living thing on the earth become extinct. But today, this process is taking place at much faster rate. This is a threat for the whole living world. Okay, students, take out next page. Page number 92. Here we are going to see global effort for protection of environment. What we are doing to protect our environment, that is our effort. Activity which has been carried out by us to protect our environment is the efforts taken by we people. Okay. So, global efforts for protection of environment. Several projects are being implemented at the international level to maintain the balance in the nature. It is important to raise awareness of the people all over the world about the threat of environmental balance. Many countries of the world are enacting laws that will help to prevent the pollution of air, water and land. Efforts to maintain the biodiversity. Biodiversity parks are made. Okay, that is an area which is reserved for the purpose of protecting animals and conserving biodiversity of the region is said to be the biopark. Aap samajh sakte hain biopark kya hota hai? You can see here the picture is also shown ki jahan pe animals reh sakte hain. Ek aisa park जहाँ पे हंटिंग प्रोहिबिटेड है, वहाँ हम ना तो शिकार कर सकते हैं, ना हम बिल्डिंग बना सकते हैं, हम कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते, क्योंकि दैट एरिया इज अंडर कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. एंड इफ वी डू एनी एंड इफ वी डू एनी हार्म टू दिस रीजन or we can say deforestation, then they will take strict action against the person who do this deed. जिसने भी ये काम किया है उसके अगेंस्ट में स्ट्रिक्ट एक्शन लिया जाएगा. ओके, सो सम ऑफ द रीजन्स हैव बीन रिजर्व फॉर द एनिमल्स सो दैट दे कुड लिव पीसफुली इन देयर एनवायरमेंट. सो इन दिस मैनर we have somewhat try to maintain biodiversity. Okay, national parks have been made where animals are kept safely. Some area which are important for the protection and conservation of wildlife are reserved for them. For example, the Kaziranga National Park sanctuaries. Certain forest area are reserved for the protection and conservation of particular animal or plants. Such area is called as sanctuaries. For example, Radhanagari sanctuaries for bison. If the plants on the earth are destroyed, the number of animal also fall. That is why it is necessary to protect the plants in the forest. If deforestation is stopped and instead tree plantation is stepped down. Animals that depend on plants will get protected and thrive. So they can stay over there peacefully in the environment. Okay, so take out next page. Mayani Lake has formed due to a dam built on the Chand River in Satara district. Flamingo from Siberian region in northern Asia migrate to this lake. Just imagine, where is Siberia and where is Satara? This flamingo is migrating from that place to this region. Okay, because such type of environment is made over there. Here, they build nest and lay eggs. Once the baby bird, grow big enough, they return with them to Siberia. In the recent past, as a water level in the dam has fallen, the flamingo had stopped coming. Is that clear? So there what has happened, the water level in the dam was less, and that is why these birds, they were not coming to this area. Okay, however, the lake has now been declared as sanctuary for birds. There is Maldog Sanctuary at Nanaj in Solapur district. These huge weighty birds are famous for their graceful gait. These birds live in open grassland. They feed on insects. As they are hunted for their meat and egg, their number is fast dwindled. मालडोग पक्षी को मीट के लिए हंट किया जाता था, उसका मटन खाते थे, तो जिसके कारण ये पक्षी अब कम होने लग गए हैं. महाराष्ट्र स्टेट हैज डिक्लेयर दैट नानज एरिया अ सेंचुरी फॉर द ग्रेट इंडियन बस्टर्ड डियर आर ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द ग्रासलैंड्स. फीमेल बस्टर्ड and the deer. You can see here the picture, students. Here female bustards are also there and deers are also there in the sanctuary. About 50 km from Pune, on Pune Ahmednagar highway, the village of Morachi Chincholi is famous for this peacock population. The old well looked after tamarind tree here have created a favorable environment for the birds. Pea falls have found sanctuaries in this village. Devrais, a boon for all living creatures. You can see here the picture, students. Devrais have been made. See, here is a picture for Devrai, and this is also a close picture of Devrai has been taken. Indian culture gives importance to the protection of forest. The Devrai is an example. People believe that Devrai is a जंगल रिजर्व फॉर गॉड. कुछ लोगों को ऐसा लगता था या कुछ लोगों का ऐसा मानना था कि जंगल जो है वह देवताओं की भूमि है. देवराई इज रियली अ जंगल रिजर्व फॉर गॉड. ठीक है, एंड नो ट्रीज और प्लांट इन देवराई इज एवर कट. कभी कोई भी देवराई के ट्रीज कभी दैट इज वाई ऑल ट्रीज इन देवराइज आर सेफ एंड इवन टूडे दे आर सेफ. ओके सो दैट इज वाई ऑल द ट्रीज इन देवराइज आर सेफ इवन टूडे. महाराष्ट्र हैज मेनी देवराइज. इन मध्य प्रदेश दे आर नोन एज श्रावणवन. देवराइज गिव शेल्टर नॉट ओनली टू द प्लांट्स बट ऑल्सो टू द एनिमल लिविंग देयर. हैंस देवराई कैन बी कॉल्ड एज सेंचुरी ऑफ एंशियंट टाइम. सो स्टूडेंट्स विथ दिस आई एम फिनिशिंग द टॉपिक ऑफ एनवायरमेंट एंड अस दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 18. ओके सो नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू गो विथ आवर होम असाइनमेंट.